Welcome back inside of the Dynasty Draft Room. It is another episode of the Draft Seminar. My name is Matt Hicks, and I'm joined by the Gridiron Scholar, John Lobb. Today, our lesson is on Vanderbilt running back Keyshawn Vaughn. And without further ado, John, I'm going to let you jump right into this running back.
You know, very interesting player, and you really have to put him in context in order to make an evaluation, my friend. Senior year of high school, he was named Mr. Football in Tennessee in 2015. But he originally enrolled at Illinois before transferring to Vanderbilt and actually taking a redshirt season. He was so good for the Illini, my friend, he earned two varsity letters. He actually led the team in rushing as a freshman with 723 yards and six touchdowns. So he was very good at Champaign. He was playing very well, but he decided to go back to Vanderbilt, his home state. Now, when he finally got in the field in 2018, he was just simply sensational. He was set a second. Excuse me. Can I start? Can you edit?
You're good.
Okay. He set a single season rushing yards. He finished second all time for the Commodores with 1,244 yards rushing and 12 touchdowns. What a sensational season, my friend. Now, the Commodores last year, if you would watch them like I did, they had so much talent on the offensive side of the football, but they collapsed once senior Kyle Schumer graduated. They just could not get productivity at the quarterback position, and Vanderbilt did not play very well. But when the dust settled in 2019, Vaughn had played in 12 games, and he rambled over 1,000 yards, and he had nine touchdowns. So he was very good despite a very poor football team on the offensive side, Matt.
I think you gave a great introduction to Keyshawn Vaughn there, John, a guy that I'm very passionate about. I'm making sure that everybody knows about Keyshawn Vaughn because at times he displayed some really high-level traits and had some flashes of brilliance, but you're right, he was trapped behind a struggling Vanderbilt offense, and I think struggling might be putting it nicely for them. But John, let's dig into his overall profile a little bit and talk through his overall college statistics, because like you mentioned, he did have time in the Big Ten at Illinois as well as in the SEC with Vandy.
So he was productive in both conferences. He has 3,296 career rushing yards. And as I said before, he had posted back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons for Vanderbilt. So I really like the productivity. What I like a lot is he had 5.8 yards per carry. Look, he's not playing for Michigan, Ohio State, Georgia here. He's playing for Illinois and Vanderbilt, and he almost got 6 yards per carry. I like that a lot. I'm very impressed. Now, he was very slow in the pass catching, but he ended up with 66 career receptions. I'm looking for a benchmark of 50 because I want to draft backs who can be on the field three downs. Now, he has some concerns as a pass blocker, but he can catch the football. Now, what I'm really impressed with for the 2019 season, this is an incredible stat in my opinion. Team scrimmage yards distribution. How many yards did he gain percentage-wise for the entire offense, Matt? He had 36% of the Commodores' offense, and he had 1,298 yards from scrimmage. So he's productive on a bad team in a great conference. I love that, Matt. It checks a lot of boxes.
All right. I like it, John. That's a really good introduction here. This is a good time to mention, if you're watching the video version of this on YouTube, you can make sure to go ahead and subscribe to our audio podcast, the Dynasty Draft Room podcast on Spotify or Apple Podcasts. If you're listening to the podcast, you can also check out the videos online where I'm about to give a full minute-long breakdown of the traits of Keyshawn Vaughn and his strengths. So let's go ahead and jump into it here. Keyshawn Vaughn, the running back out of Vanderbilt, starts off here with a really great acceleration. He oftentimes didn't get to show this because at Vanderbilt, he didn't have a lot of holes to break through, but his straight line and downfield speed is really incredible. By the way, just to note, all these highlight videos are at 75% speed, so he's actually moving even quicker than he is. than he looks like he is. He's super elusive in tight spaces. I think his ability to navigate in between the A and B gaps is really outstanding. I also think he has an uncanny knack to recognize when to bounce outside of the tackles, but for the most part, he's willing to work in between. By the way, I'm not sure anybody has a better celebration than Keyshawn Vaughn's jet plane celebration. He's super explosive. He bursts off the line of scrimmage. The type of burst that made NFL teams like Josh Jacobs last year, I think Keyshawn Vaughn displays that as well. And I think he has high caliber vision. His ability to find holes and be productive playing in the SEC behind a terrible offensive line really shows his ability as an overall back. That is my minute breakdown on Keyshawn Vaughn. But John, did I miss anything there?
No, you did a very nice job, but I'd like to add a few things. I really like his size. 5'10", 218-pound redshirt senior. I'm very excited about see how he tests at the combine, because he could be one of those players who blows it out of the water athletically, but because he didn't have great blocking, you don't always see it on film. But there are spurts when you see that incredible athletic ability. Now, I believe he's going to be better as a zone runner. Boy, does he identify cutback lanes, and he explodes through the hole. He's constantly churning his feet, and he fights through contact. I like how he lowers his pads, and he hits people. I believe he has very good vision and contact balance. As I mentioned before, he's a good pass catcher with soft hands and good vertical speed. Now, this year, he really illustrated his pass catching with 28 receptions, which was a career best in 2019. Now, I am worried about his pass protection. That is a major concern. We're going to have to read reports and see what he does in training camp and preseason. If he can improve on that, he's going to be able to earn the coach's respect and get on the field. Right now, I have a third-round grade, and this is a wonderful class of runners. It's nothing against him. I just think it's so strong, he's going to go in the third round.
And John, I think that's a great analysis here, and there is nothing wrong with going in the third round as a running back in this year's NFL draft. We project him in a similar role here at the DynastyDraftRoom.com. We have five different analysts that churn different levels of tape here. We have about 10 different tape sessions on Keyshawn Vaughn, and we currently project him with a grade of 82.6, which means we project him to be a mid-level starter in the NFL. So we have high hopes for him as well. That is our breakdown on Keyshawn Vaughn, the running back out of Vanderbilt. Make sure to go ahead and subscribe to the audio version of the podcast, the Dynasty Draft Room. Search that on Spotify or Apple Podcasts. Also, make sure to subscribe on YouTube, the Dynasty Draft Room. John Lobb, the Gridiron Scholar, is on Twitter at Gridirons, S-C-H-O-L-91. And all of his profiles can be found on footballdiehards.com. That's all of his 2020 rookie NFL draft profiles on footballdiehards.com. Also want to give a shout out to @MasterJune70 on Twitter for our graphics. Class, pencils down. That is the end of our lesson. And we look forward to you joining us for our next episode of the draft.